Today we're going to talk about the National Water Quality Assessment Program, and part of a component of that is our agricultural chemical transport study. This is a study looking at the effects of agriculture on water quality at 7 different sites across the country. And today specifically though, we're going to be talking about an area in northwest Mississippi. Our Mississippi alluvial plain is commonly referred to as the Delta. And we're going to talk to some farmers, we're going to talk to some scientists, and we're going to take a little bit of a tour of the Delta. Clara, what have you been working on as far as part of the agricultural chemical transport study?
I've been working on a paper regarding metolachlor movement throughout the environment. Metolachlor is an organic chemical that's applied, it's an herbicide, so it is usually applied before they plant, it's pre-emergent.
And where is the study area that you're looking at for this?
So you have pretty good coverage of the United States. You have the Mississippi, California, and the San Joaquin Valley. We have a study in Maryland, and we have a couple in the Midwest. So we have Indiana, Nebraska, and all these areas that we were studying are agricultural areas. So we wanted to understand how the agricultural chemicals that are applied to increase the productivity of crops move throughout the environment after they're applied, where do they go, and basically have a good idea of what's going on across the U.S.
So what would be the most significant results you found so far?
I've found that it's really interesting that a lot of the areas have similar allocations of metolachlor and its degradates throughout the 7 environmental compartments. But where you apply metolachlor, where it's used, you are going to find it or its degradates, and you're going to find them in every single environmental compartment through which water flows. So that's an important thing to keep in mind about chemicals in the environment.
That's great. Thank you.
Thank you.